Hi guys, Jordan with Motion Array, and today we're learning how to rotoscope. So what is rotoscoping? Well, it has a couple slightly different definitions depending on which field you're in, but in video editing, it's basically the process of tracing around an object so that you can isolate it. Usually, people will use this term when talking about tracing around an object that's moving, as well as one that doesn't have a simple geometric shape. An example that you'll see a lot is masking out a person so that you can separate them from the scene that they're in. Rotoscoping has so many applications within different processes and tools inside of After Effects, so learning how to rotoscope properly early on in your After Effects career is essential. So let's go through an example together. Say for example that we have a subject here and we want to put text behind them, but putting the text layer beneath our clip just makes it invisible. We need to actually tell After Effects that our subject is unique from the rest of the scene. And this is where rotoscoping comes in handy. To start, grab your pen tool and make sure that your clip is highlighted. Having it highlighted will ensure that when you start to actually draw a shape around your object, you're actually masking them out as opposed to just creating a solid shape layer. So with the pen tool, whenever you click, you create a new point, and wherever you click next, it will connect to the previous point. Do this around the entire perimeter of your object in order to mimic their shape. A great way to get fast and detailed with this is to have three shortcut keys memorized. First, your mouse's scroll wheel or your trackpad. Scrolling with either of these will let you zoom in or zoom out. This will help you get really close in to get some detailed work. Then hit H to pull up your hand tool, which will let you pull around the frame and get perspective without touching any of the elements in your composition. And then finally hit the G tool to go back again to the pen tool and keep working. Another thing to note is that if you simply click and move on, it'll make a perfectly sharp angle to the point of your mask. But if you click and drag, you can give curvature to your points. This can help if you're masking around circular or rounded objects. Now continue to trace around the rest of your subject. Now that you've rotored out your entire subject, click the first tracking dot and connect the shape to the beginning, and you'll create a mask. From here, your subject should be separated from the rest of the scene, but you'll also see that the rest of the scene goes away. This is because the mask is telling After Effects that this is the only thing that you want to show. You can inverse this mask pretty easily if you want the opposite effect by going down to your dropdown, mask, and then hitting inverse. But what we actually want is for everything to still look the same, but just to be able to work with our subject in isolation. To do that, we're going to duplicate our video layer by clicking it and then hitting Ctrl or Command D. Now we should see that we have two identical video layers, and if we go to the bottom layer, go to Mask, and then click and delete it, we can see that our scene looks completely normal, but it's actually still got the mask we originally set up. Now let's bring some text in, and then move it in between our two video layers. And we can see that our effect looks like our subject is actually closer to us than the text is, giving us a bit of depth. But it doesn't look perfect, and there's some places where the mask is cutting into our subject, and other places where it's too far away from our subject and cuts into the text. While finessing these points is a part of the task of rotoscoping, what can really help is to feather your mask. Go down to your mask options and increase or decrease the feathering depending on the situation and what looks best for your shot. For us, increasing the feathering a bit makes things look really natural. But here's the problem. We've done this for the frame that we're currently on, but this is a video, and if we play our video, the mask stays exactly where it is and we're left with a terrible looking effect. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the reason why a lot of people don't like rotoscoping. It's because it needs to be accounted for in every single frame of the video that you're working with. So what this looks like is bringing your video back to the first frame that you set up the mask for, then hitting the keyframe stopwatch on mask path. Then go frame by frame to move your mask around so that it fits right for each individual frame. This can seem insane to some people, so let me give you a couple pointers to hopefully make the whole process a little bit more manageable. If you've got a full-sized keyboard, you can actually go backwards and forwards by one frame at a time by hitting page up or page down. This can help you quickly navigate forwards and backwards frame by frame in an instant. Next, every time you make a change, as long as your stopwatch is still highlighted blue, After Effects will automatically make a new keyframe where you make a new change to the frame. But what it also does is average the changes out made over the course of any multiple frames where there's no keyframes in between. So if you have a very simple movement of your subject over the course of a few seconds, you can actually simply have your starting keyframe move down the line and then adjust for the end frame. And depending on your shot, the mask might actually work if your motion is consistent and linear. If not, dive into where it doesn't meet your expectations and adjust. You can also use this method to a smaller degree, between 5 to 10 frames at a time, to significantly cut down on the amount of finessing that you'll have to do. But guys, that's just been a basic overview of how to rotoscope in After Effects. Like I said, this is a skill that's essential the deeper you get into After Effects, so the more you practice, the easier you'll make things for yourself in the future. But guys, that's it for me. If you like this video, consider liking it, sharing, subscribing, and all that good stuff. You can also check out all of our other tutorials over at motionarray.com. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I can't wait to see you in the next video.